Both ocean currents and winds influence the Earth's climate, and they also influence each other. So when the winds blow over the ocean surface, they create current, and current carrying warm or cold water can influence the wind speed that's blowing over it. Understanding this interaction allows us to better understand how the energy moves between atmosphere to the ocean and vice versa. Think of a police gun radar that measures the speed of moving vehicles. So DopplerScatt has some of the same characteristics. That radar can measure the speed of the vehicle coming towards or away from the policeman. So what we do is we fly DopplerScatt over the ocean surface and we point its antenna in 360 degrees using a spinning motor so that we can view the ocean surface from different angles. It pings the ocean sending the microwaves out and waits for the return that comes back from the ocean surface. So the higher the return power, the higher the wind speed that blows over the ocean. Within that signal, we also have information about the relative motion of the ocean with respect to the instrument. Whenever possible, we actually like to trial our techniques and instruments in an airborne environment. This allows us to tinker with them until we get them right, and this is on an allowable cost as opposed to a spaceborne mission, which is a lot more expensive. To literally get DopplerScatt off the ground, the JPL team collaborates with the NASA Armstrong team that own and operate the King Air B-200 aircraft the DopplerScatt flies on. DopplerScatt is an amazing earth science technology because it allows us to simultaneously measure ocean surface currents and winds from this single instrument. So it's sort of like getting a 2-for-1 deal.